A field on Hampstead Heath. Not the most obvious home for a radio station, but one of the long list of sites used by the pirates to pump out 8 hours of community programmes each Saturday. This mock setup shows how basic the equipment is. A portable transmitter, wire aerial and cassette machine.
Just tuned in? Can't figure out what you're listening to? This is the message on our radio.
The pirates say the Home Office have stepped up raids on transmitter sites like this tower block in Cricklewood. They say they've been buzzed by helicopters and chased by Home Office men disguised as lift mechanics. They say that 5 weeks of raids have cost the Home Office £30,000 and netted just £150 worth of equipment. But then their broadcasts are illegal.
The trouble is there's no other way really of protesting against the Wireless Telegraphy Act. I mean, you can't go on strike and you can't even do anything except sort of political work to try and get around the act. So what we've done is a form of direct action to actually give people the service which we hope they will get legally in the future.
Isn't most of what you broadcast, though, political?
Well, it depends what you mean by political. I mean, if you think programmes by Poles, gay people, women and squatters is political, yes, we are political.
The idea behind our radio has won support in the GLC, who are pressing the government to legalise community radio stations.